the best book and see here. She couldn't even go to the temple. She was excluded from there. She was shut off from corporate worship. And they worshiped the Lord God by himself. You know it's all right to worship by yourself. But sometimes you need somebody. And do shopping on the streets. Lord have mercy. Could you imagine the term exclusion? Hallelujah, the isolation that this woman had to live in for 12 long years. Somebody hollering up, please. People's hallelujah. If you're sick for too long, and people will start saying you must have did something, they'll start saying God is punishing her because she's supposed to be sick. She's so cold. But why is that? Is that happening to her? But you got to remember, the word of the Lord said that what is Christ that suffered in the election. With the feeling of your infirmity. I've been there before you. I tried to get it for you. Sometimes God help me. The Lord of our crisis is coming out loud to draw us close to him. But you find glory to God when one thing happens right behind another. And if you steady going out the door, that's not what it intended to do. We want God healing. We want God to work a miracle for us. I don't have time for you. Don't thank God. But I hear you. So you can run fast for the devil. You're not gonna do it. Yes, he can. But you can come to a man of God. It's winding up glory to God. And when we look up and we see glory to God, say, what will you have done? Glory to God. When a loved one dies, if you don't stay before God, you'll find yourself blaming God. Some of us blame God. Some of us get an unforgiving spirit. Not going to forgive for what she did. For what he did. And hear the word of the Lord say, that if you don't forgive, I'm not gonna forgive God. I'm not forgive God. I'm not gonna help me. I'm not with my soul. I'm not gonna forgive you. I'm looking at either. But Jesus said, you got to forgive. You got